Alright guys, I'm back. So here we go. We're going to be ready to take on the boss now. So in the last episode we finished up most of Dragon Roost Cavern. Got the boss key. We also defeated the mini boss and got ourselves the grappling hook, which was probably the main event of the video. So now we can grapple across things and access areas that we couldn't normally access before. So yeah, that's good. It's basically just like a temporary hookshot for now. Alright, so we're going to go in the pot, and this will take us straight to where the boss is. If you have to go in this pot, and then there's another pot, and then you have to go in the other pot, and that'll take you straight back to where he was. If you came into the entrance from the boss room pot. There's always usually a pot outside the boss room. There's usually a pot like halfway through the dungeon. And then there's always a pot at the start of the dungeon. So there's like beginning, middle, and then end. That's how it works. Which I think is kind of convenient, because then that helps you get around the dungeon a lot quicker. So, you know, if you... Like normally in Zelda games, in a lot of dungeons you do have to backtrack. So that's like one of the cool features that they put in this game, is that you could just travel back to different points in the dungeon, which makes things easier to get around. Places to access treasure chests that you can access upon entering the dungeon, if you know what I mean. So if you had to go back, you can always just do that. So let's see what we get. We got a nice crest. These are the items that you get off Iron Knuckles and Dark Nuts. So yeah, I know what you do with these. You have to give them to the dude on Outset Island, the one who taught you the sword training. The one who did sword training. To speak to that old guy, and I don't remember what he gives you for turning those in. He probably just gives you rupees, if anything. Like I say, it's been a while since I last played this. I'm just going off based on memory, but my memory might not be 100% clear necessarily, so anything that I do say is just based on assumption, pretty much. Right, so just to be on the safe side of things, I am going to grab myself a fairy. Because I don't know if I'm going to die. I mean, there's a possibility that I could. You got a fairy in your bottle. When your life energy runs out, you collapse from exhaustion. This fairy will replenish your health. So it's Y, Z, or X, and use it if you want to replenish your energy immediately. Alright, so here we go, guys. Time for boss time. Boss time. This boss is, it's kind of a nuisance. You have to use the grappling hook, and like to use the grappling hook, you have to stand still in one place, and you have to get your aim right. So it's all about aiming and timing, pretty much. And you also have to make sure you don't rope into him as you're trying to swing to certain places. But once you get the whole grappling hook section out the way, this boss is a piece of piss. To put it in a lighter word, or in a lighter way. I want to say a light word, because piss. Oh, why did I do that? You dummy! You dummy! You dumbass! No! I freaking thought I had... Oh, come on, dude. Okay, that was the biggest brain fart of this series so far. I used my fairy up. Because I thought I had the grappling hook already equipped on the X button, because that's what I had the grappling hook on. It was on the X button. So stupid. Well, I mean, if we manage to beat this boss without a fairy, I guess it doesn't really matter, right? Whether I used it or not. And besides, you can get hearts from up here, so if you want to heal yourself, you can do that. I mean, it's not like I don't know what to do here. I do know what to do. It's just... swinging from one platform to another, that's all you have to do for this segment. Just make sure you land on the platform, because it makes it easier if you land on it, because then you could just keep swinging from platform to platform, and this segment will be done. And then once this shell cracks, that's when the fight really kicks in. You start using your sword. Okay. I'm never going to forgive myself for using that fairy. That's just like the dumbest thing ever. I don't even know what I was thinking when I did that. I mean, could happen to anyone. I just thought that the grappling hook was pressed on the X button, so I immediately thought, because I was in a dangerous situation, you know, I was fighting the boss and all that, so I just pressed the X button thinking that I had the grappling hook already equipped, so I could get the fight started, and then I pressed the freaking X button, and then I ended up using my fairy. So, we use the grappling hook on his eyeball if we can, and then all you gotta do is just wail on him. There's nothing to it, really. I mean, he can't. Okay, why am I taking damage from this? Seriously. Am I not close enough? Man. Okay. That was probably the most butchered fight of Gohma ever to be recorded, probably. At least we didn't die, so that's something. Anyway, you guys can probably tell I haven't played this in such a long time, just by that fight. Because I could do a lot better on that. And Link was dancing in celebration. He's like, yay, I'm so happy I didn't die. Because the player didn't let me die. So anyway, we grab our full heart container. You got a heart container, your life energy has increased by 1, plus your life gorge has been replenished. Life gorge, yeah. Alright, so we'll go. You know what I always thought? Like, if you stand, like, close to this thing, you could hear, like, the sound of the, the dawn, you know, the Night of the Final Day theme in Majora's Mask, it has that same sound to it, and I always thought that, but you have to, like, kind of, I don't know if you can really hear it in the recording, but if you play it yourself and you stand right next to this, I don't know if I'm the only one that has ever thought of this, but that's just the sound it kind of gives off. You can kind of hear that sound being played in the background when the Night of the Final Day theme is being played. Like after midnight, when the clock tower has been up, and you know that weird, creepy music plays. As you know, like the final 5 hours is upon you. You don't have much time left. Anyway, Valoo should be happy now that we defeated the problem that's been causing him so much grief. Yeah, that Queen Gohma fight could have gone a lot worse. Yeah, it could have gone a lot worse. Link. It's just it wasn't a very good start, me using that fairy. Well, Prince Komali, don't you have something you want to say? I heard everything from Medley. Link, thank you so much. I'm sorry I mistrusted you. Yeah, you should be sorry for all those hurtful things you said to me. I hope I can be like you someday, Link. You will, Komali, I just know it, right, Link? Yeah, sure thing, buddy. So, Link, here. I want you to take this, Link. Giving you the thing I value most will give me the courage I need to stand up to bad things. You received Din's Pearl. This is the gem the Ritos claim was passed down from the great goddess. And then you'll see a bit of dialogue here, I think, and Valoo is like talking in Hylian. The great Valoo is grateful to you, Link. Yeah, you can't understand that. I mean, I guess you could. Isn't there like a dictionary now? Like a Hylian dictionary that kind of translates the Hylian dialect into English language? Use the wind, God's wind. That's what he said, but I don't understand. I wonder what it means. The wind, God's wind. I wonder what he's talking about has anything to do with the wind shrine that's through that tunnel. Well, we've already done that, so we don't need to. Oh, I almost forgot. The great Valoo also names you Link a true hero. I agree with him. As far as we are concerned, Link, you really are a hero. Well, I'm going to go and visit Valoo. I'll come and see you sometime with best pair of wings ever. Hey, Prince Komali. He's getting ahead of himself. Thanks so much, Link. See you again someday. Well, at least we fixed a problem here. I guess that's a good deed done for today. Except we got more business to take care of. Obviously, the world isn't completely saved just yet. We don't need to stop with a beetle ship as far as I'm concerned. I mean, we could buy pairs, but I think our bait bag is completely full of bait, which we need to get rid of. Press the X button. Yeah, it's all full of bait that needs to be used. So anyway, there's nothing else that we can really do on Dragon Roost Island for now. Now that we have the grappling hook, though, we can look for some of them treasure charts. It would seem that Ganon sent those monsters to this place. But that would mean there is no time to lose. We must depart at once for the place where the next pearl sleeps. We sail to the south. Well, we're not going to sail south just yet, dude. Don't get ahead of yourself. He wants me to point it south. He wants me to blow the wind south, so I'm going to have to play that damn song. Okay. Yeah, he won't let you board him until you point the wind going south. So you can do that and then board him, and then you can just point the wind direction in any way you want. So now you can get on him, but you couldn't before because we didn't have the wind pointing south. So anyway, I just want to check my sea charts real quick and see which ones I have. Okay, that doesn't look very familiar. That's a crescent-shaped island right there. I pressed the wrong button. We haven't been there either, so I don't know where that is. I know where that is. That is Dragon Roost Island. But I want to get the map of this place first, so we can actually have a look and see where it is exactly. So you just sail around, and you should find the fish somewhere. I don't know exactly where he is. He won't be too far offshore. You just don't want to go too far out. Boy, hold it right there, small fry. Oh, there he is. Maybe we don't even have to give him bait for this one. He might just give it to us for free. I don't know where you got your mitts on that sea chart you got there, but it looks to me like it's pretty much got nothing but seas drawn on it. It's pathetic, in fact. It's almost an insult to call that thing a sea chart, if you ask me. What's the matter, small fry? I'm just trying to be nice here. I'm telling you that you've got a problem, and you do. Don't give me that stupefied look. It makes you look like you ought to be in diapers. Just listen, okay? I'm here to teach you what I know about this island, so open up your sea chart and make it snap. Stupefy. Yeah, he filled it in for us for free, but in future you have to give him bait, so... There's a real peculiar cave towards the backside of this. Backside of this here Dragon Roost Island. Yeah, real peculiar, but I doubt you'll ever get there to see it, small fry, unless you manage to sprout wings and fly, that is, because you won't be getting there otherwise. That's all I can teach you, small fry, but I will do this for you since I'm feeling so generous. I'll send word to all my brethren living near the islands of the great sea. Good bunch of fish. If you see a fish leaping out of the water when you sail, yeah, I've already explained this, so you just feed them bait. That's all you do. So, yeah. Don't need to read that. So I'm going to point the wind in the direction that I want it to go, and I think it's north we want the wind to be pointing. To get this siege... Oh, it's northwest. Or northeast, sorry. Not northwest. Alright, so we'll get the siege chart in the next episode. I'm going to end off here, and we'll continue on next time. So in the next episode of Let's Play Legend of Zelda Wind Waker, we shall get ourselves our first sea chart, and then we will be setting out to sail to unknown lands. So until then, this is NDM saying thanks for watching, take care, release your next video.